Give me a few minutes of your time and I'm gonna show you the 5 best exercises every runner should be doing. All right, welcome back everyone. My name is Dr. Craig Lindell.
My name is Dr. Michael Lau.
And we're gonna be talking about running today. Before I tell you anything cool about running, you gotta give us a thumbs up. It really helps us out, helps get this channel out, get the word out. So give it a thumbs up and then we're gonna be running with our thumbs up. All right, but seriously, the year 2020, there's a lot of people running now. It's a free exercise, it's easy to do. You can step out the door and you can do it. And the matter of the fact is, we still need to do other exercises than just running. That's because running is a physically demanding activity. Highly repetitive forces. The forces can be up to 8 times your body weight on certain structures. And the matter of the fact is, research will suggest that up to 50% of runners will sustain an injury that is going to limit them from running. And what we believe is that 80 to 90% of these injuries are due to training errors. So we can actually limit these training errors if we actually get our body stronger. So Mike is here today and I'm glad he's here
because time to get strong.
I'm gonna put him through some strong running exercises. So let's jump into it. All right, before I tell you the secret 5 exercises, why am I holding up 2 fingers? Secret 5 exercises. Let's talk about why these 5 exercises. So if we talk about what running is, it's honestly nothing more than graceful, controlled falling. You're literally running forward and you're making sure that you're not falling on your face. So I want to simplify doing exercises for running. There's 2 phases of running. It's propulsion, it's propelling yourself forward, and then braking, making sure that you don't fall on your face. So it would be wise to do 2 different types of exercises that work on propulsion and that work on braking. More importantly, running is a single leg sport. So the more single leg exercises that you do, the more unilateral exercises that you do, the better carryover it's going to have to running. All right, it's time to jump into the exercises. Number 1 is going to be the step variation. The step is going to be working on propulsion, like we spoke about earlier, as well as actually braking when you're actually stepping down. You're controlling your body, falling back down towards the ground. So Mike is showing a forward step up right now. He's doing a body weight. That doesn't mean that you can't add weight to it. So I definitely recommend adding weight to this, depending on the type of runner that you are, the distance that you're doing. Just program the parameters for the exercise appropriately. If we're going for strength, you do less reps, add more weight. Endurance, do more body weight, and just increase the number of reps. As well as the forward step up, I'm gonna have Mike show a lateral step up and step down. So running is a single leg sport. Even though we mostly run in a straight line, a lot of the forces imposed on the body are in the frontal plane, the transverse plane, rotation. Am I even rotating here? Mike is limiting all these rotating forces right now. You can't see it, but actually gravity and just standing on one leg, it actually wants him to move in this frontal plane and this transverse plane. So we're dancing right now, but actually we're exercising. This lateral step up is gonna hit the outside of the hip more. So add weight to these if you want, but do not forget about a step variation. All right, the second exercise is going to be our squat variation. I picked the rear foot elevated split squat. People will refer to it as the Bulgarian split squat, but it's a single leg squat variation. Like I said, running is a single leg sport, so doing a single leg strengthening exercise is gonna get a lot of bang for your buck, and we're really working on that propulsion as well as the braking. So we're not gonna fall on our face as long as we're building strength with the single leg squat variation. Mike is again doing this body weight, but that doesn't mean that he can't add weight to the mix. You can grab a weight in each hand. You can grab a weight and hold it on the same side or the opposite side. Each variation has a different intention, but like Mike's doing it right now, he's switching on me, I can't keep up with him. But he's holding the weight on the opposite side, so that's gonna challenge the outside of the hip more, which is so important for runners. The third exercise, number 3, is going to be a calf raise variation. So we gotta give credit when credit is due. This one is from Chris Johnson. We like to call this a prisoner calf raise. Mike has his hands behind his head, he has his foot up on a box, and he is trying to get as long as he can and I'm literally going out of frame, but that's the goal. You're trying to be as long as you can, as tall as you can, and you're going straight vertically. With running, yeah, Mike, you can see yourself. You're going straight up.
There's no weight in the front leg, hold back.
You're doing perfectly, but this is how you want to do it. Because with running, you want to own the ground. You don't want the ground to own you. If you see someone running and they're just like bouncing around and the ground and gravity is pulling them down, they are not efficient with their running. So the more stiff that you can be and the longer and taller you can be, the more efficient you're going to be as a runner. The second exercise variation is going to be a soleus raise off of a step. So the soleus is probably the most important calf muscle for runners. And we have plenty of research to show that if you have soleus issues, you are more set up for having Achilles tendinopathy issues, or at least we know that there's an association between soleus weakness and Achilles tendinopathy. All right, number four, we gotta do some sort of core exercise. We gotta do some sort of hip flexor exercise. If there's anything that I've learned over the past 2 months, running 5 days a week, is that I need to train my hip flexors and all runners should be training their hip flexors. So this is an elevated psoas march. This is no joke for challenging the hips as well as challenging the core and challenging the hip flexors. The hip flexors are integrated and they're part of that core musculature. So working both at the same time is gonna get a lot of bang for your buck. And again, this is gonna help with the running economy. We talked about it. You wanna own the ground. You don't want gravity in the ground to own you. So being able to maintain stiffness while moving your limbs is gonna help out a lot of runners. All right, last but not least, number five is going to be a full body exercise. So Mike, I told him to grab the heaviest dumbbells he can. I don't know if he did or not. Maybe he can go back and re-rack, but that's okay. But we're doing a loaded carry. So right now, Mike is holding weights in both hands. He's just walking. This is axial loading. So running, it's an impact sport. It's going to challenge your muscles, your tendons, but your bones and the cartilage. You gotta have strong bones. And the more weightlifting that you do and axial loading, loading all the bones of your skeleton, the less risk of getting an injury related to bone or a bone stress injury. That's gonna have a lot of carryover. So now Mike's holding weights here. You can get so creative with loaded carries. So I told Mike, hey, get weights up here. And now Mike, I want you to like march, but sort of always stay up on your tiptoes. Again, the taller you can be, the longer you can be, the stiffer you can keep your body, the better, because that's gonna help with your propulsion with running. Last but not least, Mike, you can drop those weights down. And now let's get into our creepy, creepy carry. So Mike, just like we talked about, right, the soleus. The soleus is so important. The heaviest weight that you can do, the better. He somehow snuck away with a little creeper march. But we want a heavy load. You want gravity in these weights pulling you to the ground. You should feel like your calf is working and dying with this. So walk as far as you can and then drop the weights, but avoid your feet. All right, everyone, thanks for tuning in. Again, my name is Dr. Craig Lindell.
I'm very tired, Michael Lau.
And shoot us a comment. Let us know, what was your favorite exercise? If you're a runner, what exercises are you already doing that we didn't mention that you like doing? Please share with us, share with our audience, because this is a community and we like everyone sharing ideas and thoughts because we get ideas from you. So please subscribe to our channel. Please comment, let us know what you like, what you want to see more of. Do you enjoy Mike sweating? Do you enjoy his cracking jokes? More importantly, we have a running program where we show you our favorite cross training exercises. It's 6 weeks long. It's gonna help you stay running. It's gonna help you get back to running. But more importantly, it's gonna make sure that you're doing things right. So definitely check that out. More importantly, subscribe, give us a thumbs up, and until next time, see ya.